Deep Kaur, today's resource person, Professor Guleen Sidhu, and dear participants. I extend a very warm welcome to all of you in today's webinar on cybercrime and cyber laws, which is organized by the IT cell of Babbar Akali Memorial, Khalsa College, Garhshankar. I hope this webinar will enrich our knowledge about various cyber crimes prevalent these days. Now, I invite our worthy principal, Dr. Baljeet Singh, to formally welcome our today's resource person. Over to you, sir.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Respected Professor Guleen Sidhu, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, बाबा बंदा सिंह बहादुर इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज फतेहगढ़ साहब की स्पीकर ऑफ द डे डॉक्टर मनवीर कौर कोऑर्डिनेटर आईटी सेल ऑफ बब्बर अकाली मेमोरियल खालसा कॉलेज गढ़शंकर फैकल्टी मेंबर स्टाफ मेंबर एंड डियर स्टूडेंट्स गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल टू प्रोफेसर गुरलीन सिद्धू फॉर एक्सेप्टिंग आवर इन्विटेशन and agree to deliver the expert talk on the topic cyber crime and cyber laws. We fully appreciate you for finding the time to be with us despite your tight schedule. I congratulate Dr. Manbir Kaur and her team for taking initiative to organize the webinar. I welcome all the participants. The main objective of this webinar is to create awareness among faculty and students about the cyber crimes and cyber laws. I am confident that this will be very beneficial for us, for our society, and for our nation. And this webinar will be helpful to achieve the main objective of this webinar. Once again, I wish to extend my hearty welcome to Professor Sidhu and everyone who is present in this webinar and congratulate the organizing team. Thank you all very much. Stay safe and wish you and your family good health.
Thank you so much, sir. Now I would like to have the opportunity to introduce today's key speaker, Professor Guleen Sidhu, with the participants. Professor Guleen Sidhu is working as an assistant professor in Department of Computer Science and Engineering in Baba Banda Singh Bahadur Engineering College, Fatehgarh Sahib. She completed her B.Tech in Computer Science and Engineering in 1999. From Baba Banda Singh Bahadur Engineering College and did her master's in 2004 from National Institute of Technical Teachers Training and Research. She has a rich experience of 22 years in her field. Without any further delay, I would like to invite today's key speaker here. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I would first of all like to thank Dr. Baljeet Singh, principal of the institute, and Dr. Manbir Kaur for helping me in coordinating this. And thanks to you, Professor Kiranjot, for giving my introduction. Well, to start with this, I would like to tell you that we all are aware of cyber crimes. But at times, we are not sure that whatever has happened with us, would it be considered as a part of a cyber crime or it is just a normal thing? Okay, so I have divided today's workshop into two parts. In the first part, I'm going to talk to you about what are the various kinds of crime. And then I would also like to put some light upon the type of punishments that are there for the different kinds of offenses. Because most of the time what's happening is that we feel that, you know, somebody is just pestering us. I see there are many girls here and boys here. So you must be seeing that, you know, that somebody sending you an anonymous email and you think that nothing can be done about it because we don't know who's sending us an email. But once we are through this workshop, you can see that even if somebody is troubling you with an anonymous email, that person can be imprisoned up to 3 years and could have to pay a fine of, say, about 1 lakh. So once you are clear about these small, small things, people who try to make mischief will think twice before doing that. And the ones who are becoming the victims will also know that the, you know, the law is with them. It's just that most of the time we do not have the exposure and we don't know that such laws exist. So I'll just start sharing my screen. I'll give you an overview of the different types of cyber crime. I'll be discussing also, you know, with examples that what kind of crimes have already occurred so that you have an idea that what all is happening around you. And then we move on to the various laws. Okay, so just give me a second. I'll share my screen. I hope it's visible. Can you read cybercrime?
Yes, ma'am, it is visible.
Okay, okay, thank you. So, first thing, what do we mean by cybercrime or internet crime? So, see, whenever anything, any kind of illegal activity or a crime is committed through the use of internet, okay, or we say on the network, we term it as cybercrime. And computer crime, at times what's happening is that maybe it is not you know, related to the internet as such. It could be that somebody just sat on your system and hacked into your system and took out some information. So even that would be considered as a part of cybercrime, right? Like even your credit card frauds that occur. Many people say that I did not use my card, but you know, by the time I woke up in the morning, I had so many messages saying that somebody's been shopping using my card. So how does that happen? And then there could be some illegal downloading that's occurring. And if you've heard, there was this game earlier, I've forgotten, I think it was the dolphin or the shark, some fish name, wherein the people, they did something. Now, what they did, I'll explain to you when we are talking about it. But in a way, they motivated the young minds to commit suicide and to make a video of themselves while they were performing that act. And some of them were crying. They didn't want to do it, but they were stuck. Okay, now why and what happened? We will discuss that too. Then many scams occur. You know, now in India also, there are so many scams happening. There are so many net series that maybe you've seen where people are just making phone calls to old people, telling them that, sir, you won this, or, you know, this has been done, and please kindly share your OTP and the password. And people are so excited that they won something, they are more than happy to share their information. And then those people, they take away, you know, whatever is there in the account. So because of the ignorance and lack of exposure, this internet crime, it has now become a great problem. So now what's happening is that anywhere and everywhere that even if you're watching TV or your phone, every few minutes you're going to get a message from the RBI or from the banks that please do not share your OTP, please do not share your personal details. The bank is never going to ask you for the personal details, right? Even from the income tax office, you're going to get such messages. And moreover, you know, what we are discussing today, you should also be sharing it with your parents, because we people are still a little aware of what's happening around us, but our parents are taken unaware. They have no idea. They feel that it is they're obliged to give away information if somebody is calling them. So make sure that whatever you learn today, please share it with the older generation, so that at least what they can do is that they should stop sharing any kind of information that is being asked from them through the mails or through phone calls. Okay, so one of the things that occurs in the cyber crime is it's the word phishing. Okay, now although there's this diagram, but I'll just explain to you what we mean by phishing. One more thing I wanted to ask, please let me know, are you comfortable in English, or should I switch to Punjabi, or I mean whatever you're comfortable, because main aim of this is that we should be able to you know, communicate to you. So Kiranjot ma'am, if I may ask you, is it okay, English is fine, or I should just add in Punjabi, or
Ma'am, yes, it is fine.
Okay, so maybe while I'm giving examples, I might, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, sure. We'll do that. Okay, thank you. So when we talk about phishing, what happens in phishing is that maybe you get an email, right? And when you receive that email, it says that it is from SBI.com, right? So you think that it is the State Bank of India that is sending you that email. But always make it a habit that whenever you feel that you have received an email from some government organization, from some banks, please check the complete email address. Because normally what happens is it's written SBI dot something at the rate, and the rest of the part has nothing to do with the organization. Okay. So all these organizations which are with the government, they would have an extension of GOV, that stands for government.in, or it would be like .org, that is for an organization. If you're simply getting an email from SBI, let's say you belong to Amritsar and it's written sbi.amritsar@yahoo.com, make sure that this is not an authentic email ID. And then further what happens is, when you read, it says, and complete the know your customer details. Now what we do, we simply click on that link thinking ke nahi to, you know, we'll have to go to the bank. So why not we do it sitting at home? So the moment you click, you are taken to a website which looks exactly like the SBI website, but it is not. So the next thing that you should ensure is that whenever, first thing, you should never click on any links, because such links will or download anything which has arrived to you in your mail from an unknown person, because either if there is something downloadable, it is going to contain a virus. Okay. And if it is a link, again, it might install something onto your system, and you also might be taken to a website which is actually not the correct website. So even like for that matter, forget about SBIs and all, maybe you get an email that you need to update your Facebook account. So you click on the Facebook account link, okay? A website will open, it is going to pop up. Now, before you start, it's going to have a username and a password. Now, since the whole page looks like exactly the page of the Facebook website, we quickly fill in the name, we fill in the password, and we press enter. At times, what happens is immediately the page is refreshed and again you are stuck with the same page, name and password. And you feel that I had just pressed the enter. Why has this page, you know, opened up again. But just considering that maybe there was some error, so what you do, you refill the information. Now, what generally happens is when phishing occurs, you will get the look of the page exactly the same as that of the original website, but you must check the URL. URL, I mean, is the website address. That will be different, and maybe that will be of the person who is going to extract your information from that page. And once you filled in your username and password, that is saved there, right? And then the moment you click enter, then you are taken to the original Facebook site. Now, this case generally occurs when somebody wants to check, wants to know. You know, normally these pranks, small pranks like the Facebook prank, I'm telling you, this is just because somebody wants to check your messages or something. So what they do, they have this kind of page, they open it up and they say, ke, tusi mera laptop use kar lo. So you are very happy that, all right, I'm using it, I'm going to log out. So nobody is going to have my information. And at times we are very careful. ਆਪਾਂ ਕੀ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ, ਆਪਾਂ ਹਿਸਟਰੀ ਵੀ ਡਿਲੀਟ ਕਰ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ, ਕੁਕੀਜ਼ ਵੀ ਡਿਲੀਟ ਕਰ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਕਿ ਸਾਡੀ ਕੋਈ ਇਨਫੋਰਮੇਸ਼ਨ ਉੱਥੇ ਰਹਿ ਨਾ ਜਾਵੇ. ਬਟ ਜੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਫਿਸ਼ਿੰਗ ਦੇ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਫੇਕ ਐਡਰੈਸ 'ਤੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਇਨਫੋਰਮੇਸ਼ਨ ਐਂਟਰ ਕਰਕੇ ਐਂਟਰ ਕਰਤਾ, ਦੈਨ ਦੈਟ ਇਨਫੋਰਮੇਸ਼ਨ ਇਜ਼ ਸੇਵਡ ਐਂਡ ਯੂ ਕਾਂਟ ਸੀ ਇਟ. ਸੋ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਟੂ ਈਵਨ ਦੀਜ਼ cyber cafes, at times people do that because just for fun, maybe they want to download the photos of somebody, or they want to see a gay friends diyan kise diyan pictures dekhniyan ne. So this phishing is very commonly used among students also. So whenever tusi kise public place te apna account use karan lage ho, maybe email kholni hai, kuch bhi karna hai jithe thoda password enter hona hai, make sure ke tusi upar jehda website address hai ohnu achhi tarah check kar lo ke whether it is correct or incorrect. Okay, because you know it is going to be facebook.com if you are going to Facebook, but if it is to extract information from you, then it is not going to be facebook.com. Right? So all of you must ensure that whenever you are giving in your information, you are at the right page. Right? And so this is what happens in phishing. As you can see, the fraudster, the person who's going to create the fraud. So I just gave you a simple example of Facebook. This can happen that they can give you, an online page for online banking where you are filling in all the information. Okay? They make a fake site, then they send these phishing emails to many people. Koi na koi ta is cheez te respond kari danda, and they make money out of it. All right. The next kind of thing is identity theft or credit card fraud. Identity theft, we all know. Somebody steals your identity, somebody pretends that it is you, and they can access all your resources like credit cards, your bank accounts, or whatever benefits the person gets. So somebody is just faking to be you, right? And furthermore, it doesn't stop there. Ek ta hunda thode bank di information leke unhone thoda utthe fraud kar liya. They at times use the person's identity to even commit further frauds. Okay, now the simplest example of this is, many of you, while you're working, I'm not sure if you have a Wi-Fi campus there, but normally if there is a Wi-Fi campus, we do that is because that is a security check ke is time is student ne login karke ki activities kitiyan, we save that information. Okay, so we have a log wherein we maintain ke je wi-fi ko use kar raha si koi bhi student ta unne kis time to kinne time tak kita, right? Similarly, jo thodiyan emails accounts hain, at times what students do is they're sitting on the system and suddenly they want to go somewhere, so they simply click on close. They do not लॉग आउट, राइट? एंड यू थिंक के सिस्टम बंद हो गया तो साडा जिहड़ा पेज है ये भी बंद हो गया तो असीं शायद ऑटोमैटिकली लॉग आउट हो जाएंगे. बट एट टाइम्स इफ सम अदर स्टूडेंट कम्स एंड सिट्स ऑन दैट सिस्टम एंड ओपन्स द ब्राउजर द ईमेल, लेट्स इट्स जीमेल, ऑटोमैटिकली थोड़ा ईमेल अकाउंट ओपन हो जाता है, राइट? नाउ सिंस इट इज योर ईमेल अकाउंट, वॉट इफ दैट पर्सन सेंड्स एन ऑब्सीन ईमेल और यू नो राइट्स रबिश एंड मेल्स इट टू समबडी. Now, whoever receives that mail will think that that mail has been sent by you. Then, no matter how hard you try to prove that it was not me, you will be considered the culprit. So, do not share your passwords even with your best friends. One thing, and whenever you are using any if it's your system, it's fine. To thode kol hi thoda laptop hai ya thoda phone hai, you want to stay logged in, perfect, right? But make sure your phone is locked if it's lying out of your reach. Otherwise, make sure you log out, because I'll just give you an example. It happened at one of the institutes. Now, what the student did was, he just wrote an email from somebody's account to the US defense saying that I am going to bomb the Pentagon. Okay, simple. It was a prank and he never thought anybody would take it seriously. But believe you me, the US defense, they do not, leave any threat unattended. So, they traced that email back to the institute. And how do they trace it back to the institute? Through, when they say ki je tusi normal crime commit karde ho na ta thoda jehda scene hai utthe hi tusi koi evidence chhadde ho, par jadon tusi crime internet te karde ho, so at times you leave that footprint at almost 7 places, because If you're sending an email, it does not go directly to the person, right? It is going to go to the server. And then it is going to hop to the various servers. And every server, it is going to be archived. Archived means it's going to be saved. Okay? And along with saving that, from where it was originated, the address, the MAC address, the IP address of that particular system, right, is saved. So it can be easily traced back to you. So if you think that, okay, I had done it, but I've deleted it, sorry, that doesn't work here. So many of you do this. I'll give you another example that happened here in our institute. We had students in the final year. So appa jive kise bacche di chhed rakhi hundi hai. So एक बच्चे ने मजाक च अपने फेसबुक अपनी फेसबुक अकाउंट ते एक कार्टून लगाया ते कार्टून दे नीचे कमेंट लिखता दूसरे स्टूडेंट दी छेड़ नाल के ए उदा कार्टून है. ओके, सो इफ यू सी ना तो दूसरे स्टूडेंट दी फोटो सी ना वो दूसरे स्टूडेंट दा नाम किते लिखा सी, एंड देन द रेस्ट ऑफ द क्लास लेट्स से 40-50 स्टूडेंट्स दे स्टार्टेड राइटिंग देयर कमेंट्स स्टार्टेड मेकिंग फन ऑफ इट. Now, this student came up to the principal and said, ke, sir, they are doing this. Te mera mazak ban raha hai. I do not want it. And, take some action against them. So, see, we do not want that any strict action as such is taken. And we thought it's just a prank. So, what the principal sir did, he told the students that, okay, fine. He called those people. And by the time those students got to know, okay, he's gone to the principal. So what do you do? The first thing was quickly that picture was deleted, and whoever had commented on that, they had deleted those comments also. Now they said, sir, there is no picture, we've deleted it, and they apologized. But now this boy was very upset. And I think you all know that every city, no matter big or small, has a cyber crime branch. It's a different cell. Okay, so this boy went to the cyber cell and filed a complaint. Okay, so the complaint was that there was this harassment the case pata and defamation the case pata. ਕਿ ਸਾਰੇ ਕਾਲਜ ਨੂੰ ਪਤਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਇਹ ਨਾਮ ਮੇਰਾ ਹੈ ਜੋ ਵੀ ਇਹ ਛੇੜ ਹੈ ਤੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਮੇਰਾ ਮਜ਼ਾਕ ਉਡਾਇਆ ਵਿਦਇਨ 24 ਆਵਰਸ ਆਲ ਦੋਸ ਫੋਰ ਬੋਇਜ਼ ਹੂ ਵਰ ਇਨਵੋਲਵਡ ਇਨ ਇਟ ਦੇ ਵਰ ਪਿਕਡ ਅਪ ਫਰੋਮ ਵੇਅਰ ਐਵਰ ਦੇ ਵਰ ਓਕੇ ਨਾਓ ਹਾਊ ਦੇ ਵਰ ਪਿਕਡ ਅਪ ਫਸਟ ਥਿੰਗ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਥਿੰਕਿੰਗ ਕਿ ਉੱਥੋਂ ਤਾਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਡਿਲੀਟ ਹੀ ਕਰਤਾ ਫੋਟੋ ਵੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈ ਕਮੈਂਟਸ ਵੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਕੌਣ ਫੜੂਗਾ But again, anywhere you delete anything, it doesn't mean that you've deleted from there, it will be deleted from every place. Same goes with WhatsApp. Hai na? Aapa sochde aapa WhatsApp to delete karta, but no. Can anybody just guess that WhatsApp de messages kinne time tak archive ch rehnde ne? How long do the WhatsApp messages, they're retained or saved? Even after you delete them from your phone, you must be knowing all this now, since all these film stars, all these you know, narcotics, drugs cases that are coming up, everybody is being caught up from the WhatsApp messages only. So see, it is saved up to 10 years. So even if you've committed a crime and it's been 2-3 years and you think that I deleted everything from my phone and nobody can catch me, they can still catch you because it is archived. That data can be taken out from there. Okay? And that is why now, earlier people used to say that I did not write this message. Somebody had forwarded to me and I had further forwarded it to somebody. Now what has happened? If you're forwarding, you must have noticed WhatsApp had to add this feature just to ensure that people cannot deny that they were not the originator of that particular message. So the moment you write something and send it, it will not have that forwarded arrow on top of it and the message forwarded written. But if you're receiving such a message and you're forwarding it, so then that forwarded message is written. So it becomes very easy to reach the originator of the message. Okay, and you all know that this is also the national policy now, that whatever information you share or whatever thoughts that you're writing, you know, we at a point of time said that we had freedom of speech, freedom of expression, but now if the, you know, these people pick up certain words which they feel are anti-national, they can come and put you in prison, that you are, you know, into some kind of anti-national activity. So if you think that I forwarded the message and now I have deleted it from my phone, nobody is going to catch me, well, you will be caught. This issue also happened since we have all these engineers around, you know, the students keep playing pranks. One student had just texted a message. He had made the logo and everything as if the message is an email from the principal, and he'd written that tomorrow is a holiday. Not tomorrow is a holiday, he'd written that from day after tomorrow we are going to have online classes, so no more offline classes. And he sent it to his friend. Now his friend thought that it's real and he passed it on to everybody. So the next day there was a big ruckus in the college saying that we are going to have online classes. So then they were like, why are you saying that? So they said, we received a message. And just because of this thing of, you know, that forwarded and this archived information, that student was caught by evening. And then he was fined and everything. So please make sure ki je tusi koi vi eho ja prank vi play karde ho apne friends te, be ready for the consequences, because if it is taken up legally, it is a big crime. Okay, so identity thefts ਇਹ ਵੀ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਕਈ ਲੋਕ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਫੇਸਬੁੱਕ ਦਾ ਤੁਹਾਡੀ ਇਨਫੋਰਮੇਸ਼ਨ ਲੈ ਲਈ ਐਂਡ ਦੈਨ ਦੈਟਸ ਇਟ ਸਮ ਕੁਡ ਬੀ ਦੈਟ ਦੇ ਆਰ ਯੂਜ਼ਿੰਗ ਯੋਰ ਯੂਜ਼ਰ ਨੇਮ ਐਂਡ ਪਾਸਵਰਡ ਐਂਡ ਦੈਨ ਦੇ ਸਟਾਰਟ ਰਾਈਟਿੰਗ ਥਿੰਗਸ ਦੇਅਰ ਔਰ ਦੇ ਸਟਾਰਟ ਸੈਂਡਿੰਗ ਮੈਸੇਜਸ ਟੂ ਸਮਬਡੀ ਲਾਈਕ ਵੀ ਹੈਡ ਅ ਸਟੂਡੈਂਟ ਹਿਅਰ ਸਮਬਡੀ ਕ੍ਰੀਏਟਿਡ ਅ ਫੇਕ ਫੇਸਬੁੱਕ ਅਕਾਊਂਟ ਵਿਦ ਹਰ ਨੇਮ ਵਿਦ ਹਰ ਪਿਕਚਰ ਵਿਦ ਹਰ ਡੀਟੇਲਸ ਐਂਡ ਦੈਨ all the boys in the college started getting friend requests from her. Okay, so the simplest thing you can do is that you ask about 20 people to report abuse, ta thoda jehda oh account hai automatically block ho janda hai. Otherwise if you have some kind of a security check in your college for the Wi-Fi campus, so from there you can find out that who all logged in into Facebook using that account, at what time, from which system, and from there that person can be caught. Okay, or if you go to the police, you know, put in an FIR, then to very easily all the login details for that particular account can be you know, obtained. There are many movies also, maybe you have seen a few, in which all these things happen. There was one movie, it's a Sandra Bullock movie by the name The Net, in which she is working from home, she's doing everything online, so very few people actually know her. Okay, so even she's ordering her stuff online, she's hardly going to places. So one fine day, everything is suddenly blocked. And when she goes to, you know, try finding out, so there is somebody by her name with all her details working in the office. And when she, since she's also with the IT, when she tries checking her information, her name is different, but her picture is there. And she has an account of, you know, all these robberies and criminal cases filed against her, and police are looking for her. Okay, so that such cases are what we mean by identity thefts, where somebody takes in your identity, tries to be you and does things. So we have to be very careful when we share any kind of information with anybody, because such things happen. Then there can also be kidnappings. A few years ago, there was this boy. He belonged to a very influential family. I think his father was in politics also. So he was kidnapped. Okay, and how he was kidnapped? Aapa saryan nu bahut shock hunda that we put hashtags and you give your status updates on Insta and on Facebook. And he was doing the same. That time, Facebook was the thing. Okay, so we like we all do that, having coffee here, then going out with friends, having tea there. So the kidnappers, they could have a proper graph that this is his daily routine, because if somebody is actually following you or stalking you, they can see the pattern of your life, that every day from this to this time you're going to this place, you're gymming, then you go for you know, coffee with your friends, then in the evening you're meeting up here. So just from that information, definitely a friend was involved, because the kidnappers could not have gained that information if because they were not friends with him. So they just got hold of a friend and he started leaking this information, and he was kidnapped. And they were traced, but they got scared and they just did not know what to do, and the boy was killed. Okay, so at times we feel ke we are not important. Je assi pa vi rahe ha ta sanu keda kise ne kidnap karna hai, sade te keda koi you know, who's going to give ask for so much money? We are just belonging to middle class families. But at times, if somebody knows your daily routine so well, they can you know, put you in a situation ke lage ke is bande ne crime kita hai, because they know exactly etho baad tusi ethe gaye te crime scene hi oh us duration de vich us location de vich fit kar dende ne, that you are kind of caught in that thing. So that's another example that please stop sharing your personal information. And this has become kind of a social status that, you know, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. And most of the time we are doing half the things just to show to people that we are doing that. But it is actually very dangerous because you're letting many people know the details of your private life, which is not a safe thing to do. Okay, piracy. All right. Then piracy also. Now things are very easily available. They are free. But you can't just simply upload something or download something from the net which is not meant for you. You know, earlier, like these days, we have many music channels, like you have Amazon Music, where you can listen to music. That is okay. And whatever music they are letting you listen to is, they have the copyright for that they can play that music. But if you think that you can download certain things and keep it with you, that is considered to be part of piracy. And you can be imprisoned for that. I'll give you an example. There was this Napster.com. This was an American company wherein this boy started, storing songs from all over the place. And then he started sharing it. So he had made a database, and from that database, you had to pay some minimum, let's say $15 or $20 per month, and you could download any number of songs. But then the music companies, they filed a case against this Napster.com stating that, because obviously, I'm talking about, say, the 90s. Now we don't have CDs.
Hello, ma'am.
Hanji.
Sorry to disturb, ma'am.
Hanji.
Ma'am, your screen is not visible.
Okay. Just one second, Chidanal.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Is it visible now, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Haanji, okay. I think I got just disconnected. Thank you for letting me know.
Welcome, ma'am.
Okay, so I'm talking about the 90s when we had CDs and audio cassettes, and we had to buy those, and they were quite expensive. So people stopped buying because they could just download that everything from there. And in India, what we were doing, we could not have that kind of a site since it is considered piracy. There was a website from Pakistan. It was named songs.pk. Okay, that PK stands for Pakistan. And there, what they were doing was they were getting hold of all the Indian Bollywood songs and uploading it there, and you could hear anything from there. So since it was out of India's jurisdiction, people couldn't do anything about it. But then Bollywood people, they filed the case in the international law, and then that site was put down. So whenever you're sharing things, now what happens is that you can't create a database as such. You have something, you're passing it on to your friend, that's okay. But if you're creating a database for everybody to use, then that would be a part of software piracy. Right? Okay. Now, in identity theft also, there is one type of theft, that is the account takeover. The other is the true name theft. So true name theft is that I get hold of your say Aadhaar card and another thing, and I just forge in, you know, my information, and I change the picture, I use that information. So basically it is your identity, but I have just put in my picture and I open a new account. That is like you are having a true name theft, like the example I gave you from that movie The Net. The other is the account takeover. So this is normally happening. And although we say that we are very careful, I'll share an example of my own colleague. Okay, so we are computer engineers. We know everything about internet and everything. So what happened, she just received a message and it said ki ma'am aapka jo debit card hai wo aaj band ho jayega kyunki aapka KYC nahi hua. To aap aaj sham ko aake apna account usme apna KYC ke documents de jaye to otherwise your debit card won't work. To now this friend of mine, now she is working, right? And we are working from 9 to 5. And by the time we go back home, we don't have time to go to the bank because the bank is closed. And if we are thinking of going to the bank, that means we have to wait for a Saturday, that also when the banks are open. So she was a little worried and she was like, can't we do it? Now, she only said that I can't come. They said, oh, ma'am, se to aapko badi problem aayegi. To ye to band kar denge. Aaj hi band ho jayega, this, that. So she said ki koi aur option nahi hai. So he said ki chalo, hum na try karte hain, ma'am. To aap abhi phone rakho, main try karta hoon. To online aapse main information maangi jaunga. To aap dete jana. Okay? So what information did he ask for? Now, this colleague of mine's thinking that she's got this phone call from the bank, right? But it was an imposter, okay? Which was about to steal her identity. Now, what did he say? He said, ke ma'am, aap apna debit card nikalein. So, unhone apna debit card nikala, uske sare 12 digits bole, uske baad, jo humara CVV number hota hai, wo bhi bade pyar se usko diya. So, he said, theek hai, ma'am, maine yahan pe entry kar di, ab aapko ek OTP aayega. तो मैं आपको 5 मिनट के अंदर वापस कॉल करके आपसे अभी ओटीपी मांगता हूँ. सो शी सेड ओके. सो ही कॉल्ड हर अप एंड बाय दैट टाइम शी हैड रिसीव्ड एन ओटीपी. सो शी शेयर्ड द ओटीपी विद हिम एंड देन ही सेड थैंक यू. एंड विद इन आई थिंक अ मिनट शी रिसीव्ड अ ट्रांजेक्शन मैसेज सेइंग दैट 15,000 यू नो वर्थ शॉपिंग हैज बीन डन फ्रॉम हर कार्ड. Now, after that, she went running to the bank. She got her card, blocked and everything was done. So, ab dekhe yahan pe ho kya raha tha? That person was sitting on a shopping site like Amazon or Myntra, whatever. So, ye jab payment ka time aaya, to unhone aise hi kisi bande ko pakad liya, usko aisa daraya and then got that information. Wahan pe bhari, CVV, ma'am ne khud bataya. It was filled there. Then उसके बाद कोई भी बैंक जो है कोई भी ट्रांजेक्शन है उसके लिए वो आपको एक ओटीपी भेजते हैं. दैट इज योर वन टाइम पासवर्ड विच दे से यू शुड नॉट शेयर इट विद एनीबडी. एंड नाउ सिंस दिस टीचर वाज थिंकिंग दैट शी इज इन टच विद दोस पीपल शी वेरी हैप्पीली गेव देम द ओटीपी. एंड द मोमेंट यू फिल द ओटीपी द ट्रांजेक्शन इज डन. नाउ इफ यू गो टू द बैंक एंड से कि ये मेरी ट्रांजेक्शन गलत होगी मेरा पैसा वापस मंगाओ, द बैंक पीपल आर गोइंग टू से टू यू कि हमने आपके लिए एक स्पेशल सिक्योरिटी चेक लगाया है कि ओटीपी सिर्फ आप ही के मोबाइल पे आएगा. तो अगर आपका नंबर डेबिट कार्ड नंबर या सीवीवी नंबर भी किसी के पास था, दे कुड नॉट हैव यूज्ड इट अनलेस और अंटिल यू शेयर्ड द ओटीपी. सो इफ यू आर शेयरिंग द ओटीपी इट इज योर प्रॉब्लम. ओके, सो प्लीज मेक श्योर दिस थिंग प्लस ऐसे ही जैसे और फोन आते हैं आपके पेरेंट्स के लिए भी, कोई भी फोन पे ऐसे आपसे ओटीपी या आपकी कोई भी इंफॉर्मेशन मांगे स्पेशली रिलेटेड टू बैंक्स, प्लीज प्लीज डू नॉट शेयर इट विद एनीबडी. ओके, एंड आई वुड आल्सो लाइक टू टेल यू, हमारे यहाँ पे वी हैड अ पर्सन हु केम फ्रॉम द साइबर क्राइम सेल. ही इज एन आईटी एक्सपर्ट, ही इज वर्किंग विद द साइबर क्राइम पीपल. And when he had come here to give a workshop, when he opened his laptop, तो जहाँ पे webcam होता है ना, उस webcam पे उन्होंने एक paper ऊपर चिपकाया हुआ था. So I just generally asked him, I said, sir, if there is something wrong with your system, why have you put this on? So he said के ma'am, I have dealt with so many cases जिथे थोड़े जिहड़े laptops हैं थोनू पता भी नहीं चलता कि कोई हैक करके उन्होंने रिमोटली कंट्रोल कर दें and they are actually watching you all the time through the webcam that is there on your system. And this is what was happening. I just told you initially that there was this game where they forced people to commit suicide. Now, what was happening when you installed that game? ਉਹਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਐਟ ਦ ਬੈਕ ਐਂਡ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਹੈ ਉਹਦਾ ਐਕਸੈਸ ਰਿਮੋਟਲੀ ਕਿਸੇ ਹੋਰ ਨੂੰ ਮਿਲ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਰਿਮੋਟ ਮੀਨਸ ਦੈਟ ਦੈਟ ਪਰਸਨ ਡਜ਼ਨਟ ਨੀਡ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਦੇਅਰ ਇਜ਼ ਸਿਟਿੰਗ ਐਟ ਅ ਕੰਪਲੀਟਲੀ ਡਿਫਰੈਂਟ ਲੋਕੇਸ਼ਨ ਬਟ ਦੇ ਹੈਵ ਦ ਐਕਸੈਸ ਐਂਡ ਦੇ ਕੈਨ ਮਨਿਊਵਰ ਯੋਰ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਦੇ ਕੈਨ ਚੈੱਕ ਵਟ ਆਲ ਇਨਫੋਰਮੇਸ਼ਨ ਇਜ਼ ਲਾਇੰਗ ਦੇਅਰ ਐਂਡ ਮੋਸਟਲੀ ਵਟ ਡੂ ਵੀ ਡੂ ਆਪਾਂ ਕਈ ਵਾਰ ਕੋਈ ਵੀ ਪਿਕਚਰਸ ਹੈ ਜਿਹੜੀਆਂ ਸਾਡੀਆਂ ਕੋਈ ਬਹੁਤ ਸਪੈਸ਼ਲ ਪਿਕਚਰਸ ਹੈ ਆਪਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਆਪਣੇ ਸਿਸਟਮ 'ਤੇ ਸੇਵ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਉਹਦੇ 'ਤੇ ਲੌਕ ਲਾ ਕੇ ਰੱਖਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਆਪਾਂ ਕਿਸੇ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਉਹ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਨੂੰ ਟੱਚ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰਨ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਐਂਡ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਉਹਦੀ ਹਾਰਡ ਕਾਪੀ ਵੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਰੱਖਦੇ ਵੀ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਨੂੰ ਕੋਈ ਇਹਨੂੰ ਦੇਖ ਨਾ ਲਵੇ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਐਟ ਟਾਈਮਸ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਸੰਬਡੀ ਕੈਨ ਬਲੈਕਮੇਲ ਯੂ ਬੇਸਡ ਔਨ ਵਟ ਐਵਰ ਯੂ ਬੀਨ ਸੇਵਿੰਗ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਯੋਰ ਡੀਪ ਸੀਕਰਟਸ ਡੀਪ ਡਾਰਕ ਸੀਕਰਟਸ ਸੋ ਵਟ ਡਿਡ ਦੀਸ ਪੀਪਲ ਡੂ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਕੋਲ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਦਾ ਐਕਸੈਸ ਆ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਤੁਹਾਡੀਆਂ ਸਾਰੀਆਂ ਫੋਟੋਜ਼ ਖੋਲ੍ਹ ਕੇ ਦੇਖਦੇ ਨੇ ਦੇ ਕੈਨ ਈਵਨ ਸਵਿਚ ਔਨ ਐਂਡ ਆਫ ਯੋਰ ਵੈਬਕੈਮ ਸੋ ਜੇ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਖੁੱਲ੍ਹਾ ਪਿਆ ਤਾਂ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਸੋਚ ਰਹੇ ਹੋ ਕਿ ਚਲੋ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਰੂਮ 'ਚ ਔਰ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਮੂਵਿੰਗ ਅਰਾਊਂਡ ਇਨ ਯੋਰ ਈਜ਼ੀ ਮੈਨਰ ਇਟ ਆਲ ਇਜ਼ ਬੀਂਗ ਰਿਕਾਰਡਿਡ ਐਂਡ ਸੰਬਡੀ ਇਜ਼ ਵਾਚਿੰਗ ਯੂ ਐਂਡ ਇਨ ਦੈਟ ਗੇਮ ਵੈਨ ਦੇ ਵਰ ਆਸਕਿੰਗ ਕੁਐਸਚਨਸ ਦੇ ਵਰ ਗਿਵਿੰਗ ਯੂ ਸਮ ਚੈਲੰਜ ਡੇਅਰ ਟਾਸਕਸ ਟੂ ਡੂ which they kept recording and in the end you were so badly stuck there that if you would say that you don't want to kill yourself they had so much stuff against you that you could not live with that stuff okay so as a senior you know your siblings must be there younger ones unna nu tusi make sure ke jive koi bhi app ya koi game hundi hai onu fatafat apa kehne ha vi a navi game hai and mostly apa ki download karde ha jehda free hunda and free ch vi thalle likhya hunda hai tusi kade vi majority of us we do not read the terms and conditions what do we simply tick on I agree right and mostly o terms and conditions kai var jehdiyan thodiyan games vi hundiyan ne o access mangdiyan ne thodi photos videos library da thode contacts da if it has nothing to do I mean you feel that your photos are all you know there's nothing there karan jaan ha
theek ho chaliye
chaliye
Students, unmute your mic. Mute your mic, sorry.
Haan ji, Satvinder. Would you like to share something?
Ma'am, I remove him.
No, it's okay. I thought maybe if somebody wants to share something, it will be nice.
Okay. Just creating the disturbance.
Okay, okay. Chalo, I'll also wind up because I also checked the time. It's almost...
Yes, ma'am.
Haanji. All right. One second.
हेलो एक्सक्यूज मी आई जस्ट गिव
हां जी
मैम मेरा एक क्वेश्चन था
हां जी
मैम अगर मतलब कि किसी के पास हमारा नंबर ऐसे मतलब चला जाता है तो क्या वो मतलब हमारी फोन के बाकी कॉन्टैक्ट्स भी उसको पता लग सकते हैं
अगर नंबर है किसी के पास आपका तो उसको कॉन्टैक्ट्स नहीं पता चल सकते पर अगर आपने अपना फोन किसी को पकड़ाया राइट और उन्होंने उस पे आजकल बहुत ऐसे सॉफ्टवेयर एप्स आती हैं जो कि आपको ऐप अपने फोन पे नजर भी नहीं आएगी कि किसी ने उस पे कोई ऐप डाल दी है पर उससे वो सारी इंफॉर्मेशन उनके पास चली जाती है तो आजकल हम ये करते हैं वी कॉल इट सर्वेलेंस आल्सो जो हमारी पुलिस भी है ना व्हाट दे डू जैसे किसी को भी पकड़ते हैं जब वो, तो उनके मोबाइल एक बार पकड़ते हैं, साथ में रखते हैं वहीं पे, तो उसमें वो ऐसी एप्स डाल देते हैं। तो किसको कॉल किया, कितने सेकंड बात की, तो वो सारी इन्फॉर्मेशन और उनकी लोकेशन के कौन से टावर के पास हैं, तो वो सारी इन्फॉर्मेशन पुलिस के पास रहती है। तो इफ समबडी हैज यूज्ड योर फोन लाइक दैट, यू नो, आपने चाहे 10 मिनट क्या 5 मिनट भी किसी को अपना फोन दिया और उन्होंने वैसी कोई ऐप आपके फोन पे इंस्टॉल कर दी है, तो फिर आपके फोन की सारी इंफॉर्मेशन उनके पास जा रही है। ओके तो इसी से अभी आप देखें आजकल जो हो रहा है, पुलिस जो क्राइम्स हैं उनको बहुत जल्दी सॉल्व करते हैं, बिकॉज वो क्या करते हैं कि अगर कहीं क्राइम हुआ तो वो फटाफट से जितने फोन मोबाइल उन्होंने सर्वेलेंस पे डाले हुए हैं वो चेक करते हैं कि उनमें से कौन सा बंदा वहां पे था उस टाइम पे। ओके तो वो पता चल जाता है तो नैरो डाउन हो जाता है। फिर वो नैरो डाउन में देन दे स्टार्ट सीइंग के वो बंदे जो नैरो डाउन किए हैं वो किस किस से बात कर रहे थे, दे गेट द फोन नंबर्स। उन फोन नंबर पे किसी पे भी अगर शक है तो उसकी जो कॉल डिटेल्स हैं, बिकॉज कॉल रिकॉर्डिंग्स भी सारी हमारी सेव होती रहती हैं, एवरीथिंग इज आर्काइव्ड, तो देन दे कैन जस्ट गेट होल्ड ऑफ इट। अभी हमारे पीछे यू वेलकम देर वॉज दिस मर्डर विच वॉज सॉल्व द सेम वे, एक्चुअली अदरवाइज नोबडी वुड हैव गॉट टू नो कि मर्डर हो गया, इट वॉज इन माई नेबरहुड ओनली। वॉट हैपेंड, द पर्सन हु किल्ड हिम उसका फोन सर्वेलेंस पे था बिकॉज ही वॉज इन्वॉल्व इन ड्रग्स और वो 2 साल जेल में रह के आया था। सो दे वर हियरिंग ऑल हिज फोन रिकॉर्डिंग्स ऑल्सो। सो दिस पर्सन जिसने क्राइम किया ही कॉल्ड हिज मदर टू से के असी वो बंदे का मर्डर करता ते हुण असी लाश नू सटन जा रहे हैं पाखड़ा च। नाउ द पुलिस गॉट होल्ड ऑफ दैट इंफॉर्मेशन। नाउ दिस वॉज द इंटेलिजेंस, देन दैट इंटेलिजेंस कॉल्ड द लोकल पुलिस एंड टोल्ड देम दैट यू गो एंड चेक द पर्सन बाय सो एंड सो नेम, ही हैज बीन मर्डर्ड। सो दिस इज हाउ फास्ट इट इज, यू नो, जिन्ना फास्ट साइबर क्राइम है उन्ना ही फास्ट साइबर क्राइम वाले बंदे नू फड़ना है ना। सो जस्ट मतलब मेक इट अ हैबिट दैट योर पर्सनल थिंग्स जिहड़ियां तुहाडियां नेट नाल कनेक्टेड ने उत्थे किते भी कदे तुसी अपनी पर्सनल इन्फॉर्मेशन ज्यादा ना शेयर करो। ठीक है, अपनी जिहड़ी प्राइवेसी पॉलिसी है उहदे ते पूरा चेक रखो। जिवें कई बार टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस चेंज हुंदियां ने, कदे फेसबुक दी चेंज होगी, कदे इंस्टा दी चेंज होगी, सो मेक श्योर दैट ऑल योर पिक्चर्स एंड एवरीथिंग, बिकॉज समटाइम्स व्हाट दे डू इज दे जस्ट सिंपली गेट होल्ड ऑफ अ पिक्चर, दे यू नो चेंज इट। पिछे जे देर वॉज दिस बॉलीवुड एक्ट्रेसेस ऑल्सो, उन्होंने फेस ला के न्यूड पिक्चर्स दे इट वॉज ऑन, सो दैन उन्होंने डेफमेशन केस किया। अल्टीमेटली बंदे फड़े तो जाते ही नहीं, बट वाई गो थ्रू दैट होल प्रोसेस, बिकॉज वी आर द वंस नाउ एक्ट्रेसेस एंड ऑल दीज आर फेमस पीपल, उन्होंने दिया तो पिक्चर्स थां थां पई ही नहीं। बट आई वुड सजेस्ट के अपनी जी अपनी पर्सनल है, लेट्स कीप इट टू अस, वी शुड नॉट बी शेयरिंग इट। ओके एंड इन केस यू फील दैट समबडी इज चेकिंग आउट ऑन योर कॉन्टैक्ट, एक होंगे कि किसी ने थोड़ा फोन अपने फोन नाल सिंक कर लिया, सो दिस जनरली हैपन्स विद एप्पल डिवाइसिस, दैट इफ यू आर यूजिंग द सेम आई डी एप्पल आई डी सो दे आर ऑल इन सिंक, यू डू समथिंग ऑन वन द सेम इन्फॉर्मेशन विल बी देयर। आई मीन इफ यू जस्ट शेयर मेड अ वीडियो, दैट वीडियो विल बी अवेलेबल ऑन ऑल द डिवाइसेज दैट आर इन सिंक। यू चेकिंग समथिंग ऑन यूट्यूब, यू गो टू द अदर डिवाइस, देयर इन द रिकमेंडेड द सेम यूट्यूब वॉट यू जस्ट चेक विल बी देयर, राइट? या सो दीज थिंग्स आर देयर विच वी शुड बी केयरफुल अबाउट। सो हेयर आर
थैंक यू।
सम, यू वेलकम, here are some other facts that we have, like you know this 24 year old girl, she was killed, it was a very famous case and all this happened that time there used to be this website Orkut where you could make friends, and when she was murdered in one of the hotel rooms, then you know there are these children. I won't take much time here since I had time till 12:15, so I'm just have about 4 minutes. So I'll just quickly wind up. So I think you all know what things are not to be done. I just tell you that what cyber laws we have in India, which normally people are not aware of. This IT Act, it was, IT is your Information Technology Act. It was, created in the year 2000. Now, the most powerful thing in this is that it gives us the power of arrest without warrant. So if you have a cognizable, okay, cognizable is an offense where you can register an FIR. Non-cognizable offense is the one where you do not register an FIR, but you go to the judicial magistrate and you sort things there. But this Section 80 under the IT Act, it gives us the power of arrest without warrant. So if they know that this person is involved in any kind of cyber crime, they can just get hold of it. And this is what I was telling you about those four boys. From they just opened that Facebook account, they checked ke kine post kita, kere IP address ya MAC address to post hoya si. Oh, because it was still connected to the net, that where that device is. So they followed the devices and they got hold of the boys. And they did not need any arrest warrant. They were just picked, those boys and their devices. Ek ne ta apne friend de iPhone to comment likhya si. So it was the friend's iPhone that was confiscated. Although then later there was a compromise, the boys were left, but I don't think so the police ever returned their devices. So I think one laptop and three cell phones were gone. So please, even if you think that you're playing a prank, think before you do that. Because if somebody goes to the cybercrime branch, you are in deep trouble. So these are some simple things that I'm telling you, that kai baar aapa sochte hain ki computer te koi document payi hai te aapa onu tamper kar dene ha, maybe tusi apna result hi change kar rahe ho, hai na, kai log ki kar dene ke ode te pdf nu download karke ode te changes karti ha. So if you are tampering with certain computer documents, as you can see, the punishment is up to 3 years, which can further be extended, and or a fine of rupees 2 lakh. And if somebody is hacking into your system, that comes under Section 66. This is the most commonly used. Idhich vi tusi 3 saal vaste andar ja sakte ho and 2 lakh tak thonu fine ho sakta hai. And it is a non-bailable offense. Thonu bail nahi mildi, plus it's a cognizable one, so edi proper FIR bhi darj hundi hai. Theek hai? So similarly, there are many such sections. Just like you have the other sections under IPC, Indian Penal Code, these sections are there under the IT Act 2000, which was later amended in 2008. So see, if somebody is even doing a breach of confidentiality and privacy, thoda koi private cheez kise ne agge karti, ta ode te vi, there can be imprisonment for 2 years. And a fine for up to rupees 1 lakh. But it is not cognizable and it is bailable. Okay. So I'll just stop here. If anybody has any doubts or questions, you can ask.
Thank you, ma'am. Now the topic is open for discussion. Anybody wants to a question?
I think ma'am, tusi bahut vadhiya samjhaya hai, lodi nahi payi kise nu, kehda hai. Nahi ji, but I'll really like to add, generally what happens is, jive girls nu, main, I'll just like to share another case, that there was this girl who was working in TCS. She was receiving emails, obscene emails from an anonymous person. So earlier she did not bother, but then when she went to the police, there was a proper FIR and that person was caught because he was, even for sending an email, even if it is an anonymous address, he had to log on into that address from some system. So he was caught and he was imprisoned for, I think, 5 years. So normally girls face this issue that you know, somebody is troubling them, or maybe even with phone calls, somebody sending messages, WhatsApp, and generally we block, then they find another number, then they start sending messages. So this all comes under cybercrime, and there are many laws. And so people should not feel that pata hi nahi kaun hai ta sikhi nu fadiye. Sago e zyada easy hai fadna.
Ma'am, you are right. The basic reason for arranging such type of webinar is that the girls as well as the boys should know what are the laws behind
exactly.
It's not a very easy to do these type of crimes. So now the time, I am Dr. Manbir Kaur on behalf of for IT cell, VM Khalsa College Garhshankar. Feel great privilege to extend my gratitude, first of all, to Ma'am Engineer Guleen Sidhu Ji, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Baba Banda Singh Bahadur Engineering College, Fatehgarh Sahib, who accepted our invitation and spare their valuable time for us. Ma'am, it's a very informative lecture. I think this lecture was hopefully the student will enjoy as well as gain information from this lecture. I would like to thank Dr. Baljeet Singh, Principal VM Khalsa College Garhshankar, whose kind guidance keep us to arrange this type of webinar. I am very thankful to IT cell committee members of this cell who tired effort able to organize and complete this webinar. At the end, I am very thankful to all our faculty members, participants and students who patiently can say join this webinar and hear this webinar informative lecture. Thank you all. Thanks once again. Thank you, ma'am. Very informative.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. And in case any of the students have any doubts or they are in some kind of trouble, they are most welcome to get in touch with me.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Jay. Thank you.
Thank you all. Thank you. Good day.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am.